Hey guys, and today I'm going to show you how to turn a number pad into a stream deck. So let's get into the video. This is the number pad I got off Amazon. Now it's £11, but I got it when it was like £9 or something, and when I went to actually buy it, it dropped down to like £8, so it only cost me around £10.50 to buy this. But you can use the one at the end of your keyboard if you have one. It really doesn't matter. But I would highly recommend you buy a wireless one because you can use it anywhere in the room. And that is super helpful when you're streaming because you could be at the other side of the room, click a key, and you can change screen. So after when you got your number pad, or you're going to use the one at the end of your keyboard, it really doesn't matter. You will need a measuring tape and you will need to measure each key to get the right measurements before we go into Photoshop. Now, if you're using the one I got, each key is the same except zero and enter. Those are the only two measurements that are different, but everything else is the exact same. After you finished your measurements, this is when you need to search online to look up stream deck icons for free. There's a bunch of them, so go through them, find which ones you like and download them. So after when you get your measurements and you get your icons, this is when we need to jump into Photoshop. This is the Photoshop we will be using. This is a free Photoshop, but you can use whatever Photoshop you want. But if you search this in Google, this will show up and it's completely free to use. Now you will need to convert your measurements into pixels, so you need to look up a converter and just do it this way. It's a lot easier, so just get your new measurements and come back over to Photoshop. So when you're back into Photoshop, you need to click file, click new, and then you need to put your new measurements into here, the width and height, right? And then you just click new. This right here is perfect for my number pad. So when I drag over something over here and drop it in, this is now perfect. I can now print this and it will fit directly onto one of my keys. What I would recommend you guys to do is get all the icons you want, save them to the right size, and at the very end, open up a new project and drag them in like this. Make a big page, like an A4 page, and then drag each of the icons you want in onto this page and then print it off. This will save paper, so you guys can do this. This is the best way of doing it other than printing off individual pages. After when you print them out, you need to cut them down to size, and then you need to go and get your number pad and actually pop out each and every key. This is a lot easier to do because you get cleaner results, but after when you do that, I want you to get a glue stick and actually put glue onto the key, and then get your page with your icons on it and then stick it onto each key individually and then cut around it. This will make the key look like a lot better instead of just trying to line it up while the keys are still in under the keypad. I tried it. It actually makes it look a lot worse. So pop out your keys, glue the paper onto the key, and then pop the key back in. It's a lot easier to do and you will get better results. Just in case you guys don't know how to set up hotkeys in Streamlabs, I'm going to show you. All you need to do is go into settings, go to hotkeys, and now you can start setting up your Stream Deck. So if you're like me, I put some shortcuts onto my number pad, and I'm going to show you how to set up shortcuts if you don't know how to do that. On my number pad, that's now my Stream Deck, I have a button labeled Discord, so when I click it, it will open Discord. But to set up this, all you need to do is right click it, go down to properties, and right underneath you will see shortcut key. You need now to go to your keypad and click it. So now every time when I click that button, Discord will open up. If you followed all of those instructions, your number pad should be looking like this. This is very cool. It turned out a lot better than I thought it would have. There's actually a few things. This is the on button, as you can see. This is stop record and record, mute, unmute, mute desktop, unmute desktop. These are all my scenes. This is open Google. This is open Discord. This is the start streaming, stop streaming. This is the music one. And this Xbox one, doesn't do anything. It was just very lonely there, so I decided to cover it just so it would look 10 times better. And it does. I'm glad I covered it. Just to show you, without the light, this is what it looks like. It's actually really, really cool. I'm glad I've done this. The reason why I wanted to do this is because I have these already set out on my OBS, but for the life of me, I couldn't remember which button did what. So this really, really helped me because I have a horrible memory. So I decided to make it. Didn't want to ruin my own keypad, so I bought a new one just so I can stick stuff to it. And I'm really glad I've done it. I hope you enjoyed that video on how to turn a number pad into a stream deck. And I hope you all do it because it's really, really cool. So I didn't show you all of it, like cutting it out and sticking onto it, because I didn't really see the point of it. You all know how to do that. So I'm hoping you guys will actually go off and do it, because this is actually really, really cool. But thank you so much for watching my video. And if you did like it, make sure you like and subscribe to my channel. And I'm going to use this to end it. So guys, I'll see you on my next video. Peace.